Hi, welcome or welcome back to my channel. My name is Rudy and thank you so much for being here. So as this dreadful year comes to a close, I thought that it would be fun to go over some of the trends that happened during 2020 and the ones that I sort of fell into and decided to associate myself with this year. It's funny because even though we were all basically alone all year and inside the house, we as a community still managed to create trends in fashion and beauty and still did them even though there was literally no one to see them. And I am absolutely in that group of people. Guys, the list of trends that we are gonna go over today that I participated in, I have to say is one, very lengthy. So I'm gonna try and keep it very short when I talk about each one. But two, they all came from TikTok. Literally almost all of them, which means that Gen Z is setting the trends right now. I literally am a walking trend at the moment. I got my curtain bangs, I've got my little, which we'll have to talk about because that's another story and it will be part of this video. I've got my herringbone chain, I've got my crew neck. I mean, I literally am a walking trend. And I never wanted to consider myself to be basic, but I think the exhaustive list of trends that I was a part of during a year in which no one saw them would say that yes, I am quite basic. If that's what being basic is, sign me up, sweetie. I'm ready for next year. If you are new here, please don't forget to subscribe. We have so many fun videos coming up. The next couple videos, we're gonna talk about some of the things I'm glad I didn't buy during the year of 2020. And also we're gonna go over my favorite makeup and skincare of the entire year. You won't wanna miss it, so please subscribe if you haven't already. Okay, let's talk about the newness that you're seeing here if you've been on my channel for a while, which is that I got a haircut. I also got a color. It's a little bit lighter. She's got some balayage going on, but the bangs are the biggest situational change here. I did go ahead and get curtain bangs. Curtain bangs, that's trend number one that we're going to cover. It is sweeping the nation. TikTok created the curtain bangs trend because it's a good way to experience having fringe without having to go all the way. People are loving it. It looks good on like almost every face. I'm loving it. It's also really pushing me, guys, to want to do a full fringe. Like, come on. I wanna know in the comments, do you guys think that I should go with a full fringe? This is too long, you know, but I wanna know what you guys think. I actually like the curtain bangs trend. I think that it's great. And honestly, if you can find a hairstyle and a haircut that works for you, it doesn't matter if it's trendy or not, keep doing it. Like, I consider this to be a good style for me, so I think I'll keep doing it even after when a shaved head is the next trend for 2021, which, like, God save us, but I think I'll keep the curtains. Let's continue on with the TikTok trends that I have picked up on. So trend number two is tiny sweaters, little turtlenecks, and this specific sweater vest. So what I'm wearing right now underneath my sweatshirt is a dickie. And I would show you, but literally there's nothing under here for me to show you except for there's a dickie. Like, literally it goes so that you're not wearing an entire turtleneck underneath your sweatshirts. I live in the South, it's 70 degrees and it is December 12th. So I can't be wearing a turtleneck under a hoodie, under a sweatshirt, it's too hot. So I will continue wearing the turtleneck trend. I don't care if it goes out of style. And that's really the part of trends that they come and go, but if you really like something, like, hold on to it. Who cares? Like, do what makes you happy, wear what makes you happy. That's the moral of this video. And that I'm very basic, that's the other moral. So the tiny cardigan. Oh, I actually brought a dickie. I brought a dickie to show you. So this is my party dickie. I also have a business dickie, as my husband says, which is a collar, and I'll put a picture of it up here if you would like to see my business dickie. This is my party dickie. This is what I have on here. It's basically just the best way to wear a turtleneck with long sleeves without sweating your little titties off, okay? Love these. We'll link them down below from Amazon. I'm about this trend. The other little trend that I wanna talk about in terms of tiny clothes is tiny little cardigans. And this is a trend that I don't really like. This is my tiny cardigan. I do have a video of me wearing this. I can pop in a little clip here. You can't really see it, but if you have above a size B cup, I wanna say A, which, I mean, that's me, sweetie. I hate to break it to you, but I have little to nothing going on there. And if you don't want your titas to be fully exposed, I would not recommend this trend. It's basically wearing a sweater, a very tight crop sweater without anything underneath it. So I only wore this one time. This was not the trend for me as a 27-year-old woman. And then lastly, in the fashion category, we have this specific vest. Everyone and their mother has this vest right now, and I feel like I'm late to the trend because I just bought it like last week, but I don't care, I love it. It's so cute. I never thought I would like sweater vests. I love it. I'm gonna wear it all the time. I'm gonna wear it after 2020. You can't stop me. I don't care. And I will of course link it down below because I know you secretly like it too. So the next trend that I wanna talk about is actually something that was trendy because of what the year was like, which was wearing very minimal, natural, glowy makeup. This was absolutely the year of glowy makeup and very natural, let your skin show through, like we're not doing full coverage, we're not doing a full beat, we're doing a glow and that's it. And it ended up being the exact look that I wanted to go for this year, so I feel very thankful for that. I have three brands, well really four brands, that I have been really loving this year that have helped me achieve that really natural glowy look but still work on my oily skin, and I just wanted to give them a shout out. So really quickly, one is Ilia. This is their multi-stick, and I've really loved this for a blush, lip, and eyeshadow even. Ilia's been a really nice brand for clean glowy makeup that's a little bit more elevated than Glossier. I think all of these that I'm gonna tell you about are a little bit more elevated than Glossier and will give you that same look without like literally just sliding off of your face, especially if you're oily. So Ilia has been a great brand for that natural glowy makeup look. And then of course Nude Sticks. This is the Nudies Matte All Over Blush color. This is in the color Sunset Strip. I have a few bronzers and blushes from them. They also have highlighters. They have a few foundations. This is really gonna allow you to determine the level of coverage that you want for your blush, but also it's just really, really a great product if you do have oily or sensitive skin. I've had no problems with these. I still am glowy and dewy and beautiful, but I'm not sweating, you know? And then a newer product and brand to me is Kosas, and this is their Color and Light Cream Blush and Highlighter, and this is in the Velvet Melon High Intensity. They make these in regular and then high intensity, which is double pigment. And for my skin tone, this is what worked best for me. I am wearing that today. The highlight is very glowy, very beautiful. Really am liking this. Those are my favorite brands this year for the glowy makeup look, and that is a trend that I think I will continue to wear in the future. So on the other end, the other spectrum of the glowy makeup look, another huge trend this year, and a trend that sort of sparked my YouTube channel and my TikTok, is excessive skincare. Everybody got into skincare this year. People who have never given a crap about their skin started texting me, asking me what they should use, if they should start a retinol serum. Like, everybody was texting me. My mom got into skincare. My husband's mom got into skincare.
Your mom texted me about skincare.
I think people were realizing that now that we're at home, we have more of a chance to try new things and really get our skin to a good place before we bounce back into the world next year, fingers crossed. But also, to be honest, I think we as a community just wanna spend our money on beauty products, and we weren't spending all that money on makeup because we weren't wearing it as much, and so we had to put our money somewhere and it went into skincare. Skincare has turned into a huge business. I feel like every celebrity has their own skincare brand right now. I just saw JLo release one, which is based in olive oil. The entire brand is based about olive oil, and I just, that's for another day. But I can definitely say that I fell into that trend as well. I've always been really interested in skincare, as you guys know, very interested in learning about different ingredients, how it works with my skin, and different acne medications. And so this year, I've really gotten a chance to talk to a lot of different people and talk to you guys about my skincare routine, the different skin problems that I've dealt with over my life, and how I sort of fixed them. And it's been so fun to connect with you guys and to help you in literally any way. So absolutely, skincare was a huge trend this year. If not, I would say the number one trend. I feel like it was 2020. Like, skincare started for everyone in 2020. So related to skincare, I feel like people were starting to purchase more silk products this year, and I feel like that was definitely a trend, and it is one I fell into. I use both silk pillowcases and silk scrunchies, which scrunchies are also a trend for this year that I fell into. But I feel like adding them together, it is a super trend, which is the silk scrunchie. When I was dealing with some fungal acne during the summer, I was feeling really, really down about myself and was falling into that spiral of buying skincare and buying things to try and make my skin better, because I know how that goes, trust me. And I bought a silk pillowcase from Slip, which is a very expensive brand. I did get it at Sephora. I can link it down below if you're interested. I do feel like there are some dupes. I like the Kitsch silk pillowcases and also the Lily silk ones from Amazon. I can link all that down below. And I do use the Lily silk scrunchies. They're really nice. They come in like a 5-pack. I actually talked about them in a quarantine Amazon favorites video, so I can link that down below if you want to kind of see them in action. Which, side note, do you guys like Amazon videos? Because I could do like another 20 of them, like minimum. I have so many things from Amazon in my house, but I know people have different opinions about that. Let me know if you like those. I do have a few already on my channel in a playlist I can link below. If you wanna see more about those scrunchies, you can check that video out. I really like them. I don't really know if it does anything for your skin or your hair based on my personal experience. However, I'm pretty sure everyone recommends silk pillowcases. Even the dermatologists on YouTube and TikTok recommend silk pillowcases for people with acne. Dr. Dre recommends it, and as you know, I trust her with my life. I do like it. It is a very cooling, luxurious experience, but if you don't want to spend like the $89 for a slip case, I would go with a Kitsch one or the Lily Silk. Let's talk about a hair trend that I fell into and that I am so glad that I learned about, which is the Revlon hair dryers, the Style Curl and Volumize hair dryers. So this one is new to me. This is just the box, but I have also the giant one, which I talked about in a summer favorites video. If you want to learn more about that, I have a really big one that's like a wide flat comb. And then I have this one, which comes with a 1-inch brush and a 1.5-inch brush for curling. And that is what I used today to get this kind of like slightly curled, blown out look. I used the 1.5-inch brush on my mane hair and then the 1-inch on my bangs. This one is very inexpensive and it's definitely rickety. I'm not gonna lie to you. Like, this silver part here gets really, really hot. And if you touch it, you literally will burn your hands off. So you have to be really careful about how you use it. And even on the low setting, it gets really hot. But it is nice because it also comes with like a nozzle for if you want to just do a fast dry and then go in with the curling wands. I do like this a lot. It is very inexpensive and you have to be very careful or you will burn yourself. I do like the other one better, the fatter one, for like an all over really fast blowout look. They are amazing. I feel like I've never been able to achieve the blowout look that you get at the salon at home with my hair dryer and a round brush. I freaking hate it. I've tried using a round brush many times and I just can't do it. It's very hard. It makes your arms tired. These are definitely the way to go, in my opinion. They are fast, easy. You're gonna wanna use good heat protectants with these products because it is a lot of heat being applied to your hair. But since I got them, I have not touched my straightener. Highly recommend them. I love that trend. It's been a lifesaver for my hair and I can't wait to, you know, kind of play with it a little bit more and see if I can get more of a curl out of it. Let's talk about possibly the biggest trend of the entire year. I actually asked my friends on Instagram, if you're not following me on Instagram, it's at Rudy Lauren. I can leave it down below. I asked what the biggest trends of the year were to get some feedback, and I would say 90% of the answers I got were loungewear sets. And I would have to agree. I made an entire video about Amazon and Target loungewear sets during the summer when they were really picking up. A lot of them were in tandem with another trend, which is tie-dye. Tie-dye came back this year, which is funny because I feel like tie-dye was cute when we were 10, 12 years old, and now it's like a cute adult version tie-dye. I do have a loungewear set, two actually, that are tie-dye from Amazon. Like I said, I can leave that video down below. I try them all on. I've really been into the loungewear rompers. I think matching loungewear sets are a great way to feel good about yourself during quarantine and during all of this time. Have something cute on that matches without feeling like you have to wear jeans. I'm wondering if we're gonna wear any of these, you know, once life goes back to normal eventually or goes back to whatever it's gonna be. But I don't really care because in the meantime, I'm having fun with them. I think they're really cute and I'm gonna continue wearing them after this. That's just my 2 cents on it. I will tell you one thing though. I'm not like spending a boatload on these loungewear sets. I get emails from Free People because I buy my jewelry from them. Strangely, it's not expensive. I don't understand. And their subject lines are like,
this loungewear set's only $200. Like,
guys, you're way off base here. No one wants to buy sweatpants for $200. Maybe someone does, but it ain't me. All right, only two more to discuss and I've left them at the end because they are slightly embarrassing. So let's talk about tooth gems. I'm not gonna lie to you guys. You guys know this, I have a video on my channel of me putting on a tooth gem. I can't believe this trend came back this year and I think that a lot of young people would be like, what do you mean came back? Like, tooth gems are brand new. No one's ever had a tooth gem before. Sweetie, everything that's old is new. Everything that's new is old. it's always a cycle. I don't know about you guys, but when I was in college, I had a few friends that had tooth gems that were permanent. A lot of the girls that had them had studied abroad, I guess in Germany, in Berlin, were loving a tooth gem moment. I don't know. At the time, I didn't get one. I thought they were cool. Time passed. It's been about, 7 years, and now tooth gems are back. And I thought, if there is a time to try a trend that you don't know if you're gonna like it, you gotta test it out, it's now. We're home. I'm not seeing anyone. I'm already married. My husband doesn't have a choice. He's not gonna leave me over a tooth gem. I asked. So I did it. And let's just roll the clip. It's on. It's on. Okay.
Okay.
Oh, it tastes bad, guys. Don't get that glue in your mouth. It tastes bad. I'm getting sweaty. I'm getting really sweaty. Is this ugly? It might be ugly, honestly. I don't know. I did an at-home tooth gem kit. I don't really recommend doing this. I think that if you want to have one, you need to talk to your dentist, to be honest. I don't think it messed up my tooth, but I don't really know. It also only lasted a week and it fell off while I was just sitting there. So there's a good chance that I could have swallowed it. But if you are interested in this tooth gem company that I did find on TikTok, I can leave my video and the link to their products down below. I do have like 4 left in the glue, so I'm like, maybe I should just put one on every tooth and just have a big old shiny grill for Christmas. So the last trend that I want to talk about today is one that I was like kind of iffy about at first, and now I'm like fully in, like full steam ahead, I'm doing it for life, and that is faux freckles. I am wearing some right now, but you really can't tell because I do have studio lights literally on either side of me. That's also why I look a little sweaty, because to be honest with you, I am a little sweaty. Let's zoom in here so you guys can really get a good look at things. So these little faux freckles I made with the Freck Beauty OG Freck. I was on the lookout for a faux freckle pen, and I wanted the one from ColourPop because it was like $7, and I knew that it would work just as well, and it sold out literally instantly. I don't know if it's back in stock. And so I got the Freck Beauty one, which is recommended by a ton of people, and I really do like it. It's literally this big. I think I talked about it in a favorites video, so if I did, I'll leave that down below. But it's got a little bit of a red tint to it, so the freckles look really natural. You can also kind of decide how, colorful you want them to be, how pigmented, and how many you want based on how many times you kind of pick it up and place it on your face. I think that they look more natural when they're a little bit more faded out, but I also think that if you want that really faux freckle trendy look, it's okay for them to look a little bit fake, because that's kind of what people are doing, and I think they look cute either way. Honestly, I feel like with the glowy makeup trend, the fake freckles look really, really cute, which, like, let's get this straight. I am a very hairy Croatian woman. I do not have any freckles on this face that are natural, and that's okay. We all want what we can't have, isn't that the truth? I feel like people with freckles are probably like, looky here, okay? I haven't liked these things for years, and now everyone wants them all of a sudden. And that's just the way the cookie crumbles, I feel like, with every trend. Please let me know down below what trends I'm missing, or what trends you guys were a part of this year. But I also want to know what trends we think are going to come in 2021, because once we get out of this era of life and we start into our next one, like, what are we going to be wearing? What are we going to be like looking like? What's our beauty style going to be like? I'm really curious, especially knowing like if we are all kind of ready to get back into the world by the fall. Are we gonna pick up the fall 2020 trends and place them in 2021? Are we gonna have brand new trends? All right, don't forget to let me know down below if I should do a full fringe or not. And I will see you guys in the next one really soon. Bye.